over there. Hi. Welcome. All right. Tell me a little bit about you. Yeah, I know your name's Carolina.
Yes, and I just finished my master at the Conservatoire de Montréal.
Masters, okay. Good.
And, yes, I'm starting the Atelier de Montréal in September.
Uh-huh.
And I'm super happy to be here.
And how old are you?
I'm 28.
Okay, that's always good to know because because we can judge what the physicality of the body is and everything. So it makes a difference if you're 21 or if you're 28.
Yes. But I started my studies at 21.
So oh, good. That's okay. Right? Okay. Okay. And are you actually born in Montreal?
No, I'm from the north of Quebec in Abitibi-Témiscamingue.
Where?
I'm from Abitibi-Témiscamingue.
I know it well. You laugh, but I have been all over Canada. I have sung recitals in places in Canada that you can't imagine, including Whitehorse, Yukon. Squaws along the Yukon, they're good enough for us. Remember that song? All right. So what's going on with this lovely young man? Tell them who he is.
I'm the little queen's page, so I'm here to deliver. But there's a celebration between Catholic and Protestant at the beginning of the opera, and I come in the celebration to tell Raoul to deliver. To deliver a message to Raoul, but yeah, we don't know yet that it's Raoul. I come to deliver a message to one of the noblemen. That's what I'm saying in this aria. And yeah, it's a message from the queen. It's a message from an unknown woman. We don't know it yet now, but later in the opera, we will know that it's the queen.
And what do you think about this page? His name is Urbain, by the way. Yes. What do you think about him?
I think he's a noble. He's a really, I think he really loves the queen, and that he's happy to come. And he's, I don't know how to say it. Il taquine un peu, he tease a bit all the noblemen.
He's a little bit nasty.
Oh, okay.
And actually, if you would go on to sing another aria that was written for Madame Patti when she, Alboni, when she took over the role of Urbain. In those days, she insisted that another aria be written for her. So it's called No, Vous n'avez jamais je gage. Mm-hmm. And that's really nasty. He's just hinting at it here. And he's very happy to have all of these secrets of the court that he knows and nobody else does. I bet he uses them too. Mm-hmm. All right, let's hear you do it. Have some fun.
Noble Seigneur, salut. Noble Seigneur,
Very good. Very nice. This is not an easy piece to sing. Who decided your mezzo?
It's a complicated...
Well, it can be a big question,
yes,
with mezzos, and I don't think you're a mezzo. My dear, why wouldn't you want to be a soprano? More money, best dressing room. Do you ever fool around singing soprano music?
No, not really. So I love the pants roll. I love the. Like,
I'm not sure your voice is big enough for them, though. Mm. You know, you talk about maybe the German ones like Octavian and the Komponist, and mm-hmm. I'm not so sure your voice is big enough for that. No, you sound like a soprano to me. You sound like a soubrette.
Oh.
Yeah. How high do you sing?
It's high for me. This is pretty high.
Well, this is, it sits a little bit higher than maybe you're used to singing. I don't know. But I think you should consider fooling around with maybe... Take a favorite song that you sing and putting it up a tone,
okay,
and feel the difference.
Okay.
Because I don't hear in the quality in your voice that has even a smidge of darkness. Not that I like dark singing, but there is a certain quality that comes with a mezzo soprano that's not there with soprano most of the time. It's a very tricky thing. I had problems with it myself, and the decision, it's like also so many baritones are on the verge of being tenors. Mm. That's all,
yes.
So, yeah. But you might consider, but at the moment, you sing this very well. What I would like to do is maybe slow you down a tad, mm-hmm, and maybe have you have a few more nuances, mm-hmm, of some kind of rubati and things like that. So I would like the tempo to be this. Ba-ba-ba-bum, bum, bum. Ba 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 bum, 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 okay? Mm-hmm. And then, in a dominant. job. Maybe when you sing a little slower, more voice will come out. All right. Da-da-da-bum, bum, bum. And take over.
Noble Seigneur, salut. Noble Seigneur,
now you took an extra breath this time, right? Because you needed it.
Mm-hmm.
That's so you're letting more voice out, which is good, really good. Okay, let's go on. That's it. You're telling a story now. Putting in his first bit of information that I've got something on somebody here, all right? So for one of you, right? So you're talking to all these men, right? Yeah, okay. Yeah. So when you say, ma chargée de ce message, chevalier, chevalier, pour l'un de vous. Yeah, he's got this lovely information. This is what he loves. Okay, let's go on. Good. Keep your voice coming. Now move it a little. Vous pouvez croire, just a little tempo within a tempo.
Okay.
Quoi choisir, sing that. Get into just a slightly little bit of chest voice there. Ne tant de gloire, tant de gloire de bonheur. Little.
Okay.
Wait, just a second. Vous pouvez croire que ne, Seigneur. Take a breath. Ne tant de gloire, all right? And then, ne tant de gloire. Feel the rhythm of it.
No, 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 no
Can you hold that longer? No, make the trill longer.
Okay.
You got to know that this is also show-off music.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just start from no 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 right there. Something but vos amour rhythm again. Dum dum dum. Use that you feel that martial rhythm.
Okay.
Like or sali, and then you go dum 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 or sali. Feel the rhythm always, but just make a little something out of that the end of that phrase. All right. Let's go back to or sali que Dieu protège. Right. Pa 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 all the notes. Okay, you see what he's written is que Dieu protège vos combats, vos amours. I think you can do that. Do something with the words, though. Vos amours, something with the words. Right. No, it's para, para, pa, pa, pa. It's got a grace note.
Okay.
Rhythm. Take your time. Do a little something more with it because it's the end.
Mm-hmm.
And as we know, maybe you don't know, possibly, that this goes into the rest of the opera. So people come in and sing. But I'm going to probably guess that you'll never sing this opera. It's never done, right? Very, very rarely. But you will sing it as your party piece or part of, you know, any group of French arias or whatever. So just remember, you've got to have your ending so that it really ends the piece.
Yes.
That we don't think of going into the rest of the opera. So after you've sung, pa 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 la ba ba la 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 I can't remember what you. After you've sung the C in the rundown, what are you doing?
Just so.
Okay. Dieu protège. With some élan, right? Vos amours.
Okay.
End it. Make an accent on it. And then do diminuendos or whatever. Something like that. Yeah. I know French speakers do not roll their R's, but the great French singers roll their R's and have since time immemorial, because it's lousy to sing the French R that takes you down into your throat, like the one that the Germans use occasionally too, which most of the German coaches now are selling, to that you should sing something like Mir and Fier and Mir, Fier, you know. I would say this made you sing much better because it made you use more air, use more tone in order to get the tone out. And therefore, I think you made a better impression singing this a little bit slower and with more voice. You know, the thing is, it's a big voice world out there for singers in opera. So you have to learn how to use your instrument. I think you would be very good singing this. You may not ever go to soprano, but I think it's something you need to think about. And after you do your ending, by the way, vos amours, I liked what you did before. That's what I did. Da-da-da-dum, jum, jum. Da-da-da-dum, jum, jum. Cha-da-da-dum. Do something like that. Da-da-da-da-dum. Bum, bum, bum. And then you can do ta-da, something like that. All right? Do you like that?
Yes.
Use it. Thank you. Java. Lovely. She's a lovely singer. Very, very nice. I've never seen the Huguenots either. I saw, heard it in a concert version many years ago with Joan Sutherland and with Maestro Bonning conducting at Albert Hall in London. It was wonderful to hear it. And if I recall, Martina Arroyo sang, what's her name? The other lady, can't think of her name right now. And Raul was Vreños, yeah? And I'm trying to think who else. But anyway, it was a great performance in concert. Sorry?
What's that? Who
was a Canadian? Urbain? He was a Canadian? Oh, yes, it was. Huguette Tourangeau, of course. She was wonderful, absolutely. Okay, let's have our baritone. Hi, welcome. How are you? Welcome. So tell me about you.
My name is Hugo Laporte.
You're also French Canadian.
Yes, I am French Canadian. I am 24 years old.
Okay. And you study here?
I studied in Quebec. I'm still in Quebec with Patricia Fournier.
Okay.
Teacher in Quebec. Yeah.
And when you say Quebec, do you mean Toronto or do you mean Quebec here or?
Quebec City. Yeah.
Quebec City.
Quebec.
See, I've sung there too. okay. And obviously, are you in your bachelor's or are you in your master's? Or?
I just finished my bachelor's.
Your bachelor's?
Yes. And
Good for you. That's
I started my master's, but right now I've got a lot of concerts to work on. So.
Oh, good.
I'm working on that and taking private lessons.
Excellent. Yeah. Have you made your debut in opera yet?
I will. I sang in concert quite a bit in the last years, and I will be singing in the Carmen.
With Morales.
The in August.
In Morales.
I will be singing Dancaire.
Dancaire.
And I will be singing the doctor, Le Médecin, in Pédéas et Mizan, with OSM also in Kent.
Very good.
Nice.
So, how about this? Have you ever sung it?
Yes, I did. It's an aria from Elijah, which is the center character of the work. And it's the work is, this area is named It Is Enough. And it's the area in which Elijah, the prophet Elijah, asks God to take his life because he's been working all his life to convert everyone to God. But it hasn't been successful, so he asked God to take his life away and bring him to heaven.
Good. That's a very good explanation. Now, you've sung the whole work in public?
I did not.
Because it's a great, great old oratorio, which seems to have been put a little bit aside now. It's not done very much, but it's great oratorio. It's got so many hit tunes in it. It's almost got more hit tunes than the Messiah, mm-hmm. and a great piece to hear, and great choral work, and you know, great sopranos and altos, and tenor. Everybody's got it something great to sing. So I look forward to hearing you sing it now. Get yourself in the mood. You're ready to die. Would it bother you if I asked you to do it a little bit slower?
Yes, of course.
Excuse me. What is your name, dear?
Jamie.
Jeremy. I've got to, even though it's written pianissimo, you've got to feel heaviness of soul in this. Jum, 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 da, da, da. Do you know what I mean? So you've got to be his heartbeat or whatever you want to call it. Thank you. Good. Not an easy piece to sing.
Yeah, it is not. I like it very much.
I think I'm going to suggest something and ask you. I notice you're using your jaw a lot when you sing. That's hard work. I think you might consider getting it more here and keeping your mouth closed. Now, are you using your jaw because of the diction, that you want the diction to be much clearer?
Or? No. In fact, I try to be as free as possible in this area, and my jaw tends to drop a lot instead of staying.
It's here where the problem is, to keep the support going so that it'll stay here.
Okay.
But I think you'll get a... a little more bang for your buck, as we say, if you get it here more rather than jawing it. That can get you tired throughout the evening.
Okay.
You know, that can really make you tired. I think you have to think a little bit more about your resonators. All right, let's go back to the beginning. I'm not feeling yet the heaviness of his soul at the beginning. I still feel that it's got to be, it is enough, O Lord, now take away. You have a little bit of a French accent on that. Now take away, right? I heard a little bit of a French accent. My life, so sustain it, really sustain it. And anyway, let's start that again. And there's some other things coming, but I won't do those yet. All right, let's just give him a few bars and keep some heaviness in the accompaniment, in all those beats. Now, I don't mean heaviness necessarily with dynamic, but I mean pressure, the way you're playing the notes. I'm not a pianist, so I can't tell you anything. But it's that I want to feel that the underpinnings are what he's feeling. Obviously, it was written for orchestra. I know all of that. But that's, unfortunately, pianists have to figure that out if they're going to play for singers. Okay? So if you just give us a few bars, maybe 4 or 5 bars before he comes in. It's not good. It's not take away, it's take away. That's what I meant.
Okay, you meant, okay, it's away, take away.
Yeah, you gotta, away, yeah. Again, right where you start.
It is enough, oh Lord, now take away.
What if you sang this, for I am not, instead of I am not? What if you don't open your mouth? Do it with the resonators. Start, oh Lord, now take away my life. It's away, not
okay, it's not enough.
No,
okay.
Not enough, dear.
Away.
See what you're doing there? You're going, I am not. How about right here? Put it right here. I am not. Use the M. I am not. See what I mean? Really, really sustain it. Okay, start again for it is enough.
At the beginning?
Yeah, the beginning.
Oh.
Excuse me. Try singing ah up there instead of I on the E natural. Ah, like go for an ah. I, and then just put the diphthong at the very last second. So you sing, Fathers, I am ah. And you feel a little bit of a lift, do you, in the back? Just a tiny, tiny smirky smile. That's high, it's not low, it's high. I am not better. All right, try it from, take away my life. I am not better, next to the last bar of the page.
I am not better, not better than my fathers. I am not better, I am not better than my fathers.
Try to keep it here. Get a little bit on a sound. Keep going.
I desire to live.
You know what? I'm not crazy. That's a choice, but I'm not crazy about it. I desire. I think is nicer. Just my own personal taste. Whatever, I just want to give you the choice.
Okay.
Okay, just before. Okay, right there. Just give him a bar, two bars.
I desire to live no longer.
I didn't do that. It isn't what I did. I didn't do desire, I went, I desire to, desire to. Desire to live.
No.
Yeah.
I desire to live.
No.
It's hard to see.
I know. No, it's hard to change your head. You have to change your head. That's the problem.
I desire to live no longer. Now let me die.
This place right here is where you have a shot at singing legato. After you've sung, broken thy covenant, have broken thy... Sing a nice legato in that spot. So just for the children of Israel, right there.
For the children of Israel, have broken thy covenant. A broken the covenant, and thrown down thine altars, and slain all thy prophets, slain them with the sword, and slain all thy prophets.
Wait, Maybe you have a different score than I do, but I have. And slain thy prophets. What are you singing?
I have two scores.
Yeah. Well, that's the difference. Okay.
I had slain all thy prophets.
Yeah, I have no all.
Like the first time.
Yeah, okay.
I do the same thing both
times. Okay, it's just in this score it's different. So forget it. Forget what I said. And slain... have broken thy... Now, I didn't necessarily mean sing softer. I just meant sing really legato, really smooth. Okay, let's go back again. Same place for the children of Israel.
For the children of Israel, have broken thy covenant. Broken thy covenant. Have broken the covenant. And thrown down an altar. And slain all thy prophets. Slain them with a sword. And slain all thy prophets. Slain them with a sword.
If you can do it, I like, he puts the sforzando right on the D, you know, so he doesn't have you sing and in the same dynamic as you sing I. So what I prefer, if you want to try it, and the Lord God of hosts, and I, you know, and I, even I, you just see, pull back a little bit on the tempo, too.
On the
eye. Yeah, yeah. There's nothing underneath you, you know. That's a goose egg. That's a whole note underneath. So, do you mind trying that? So, you got the Lord God of hosts and I. Lord God of hosts and I. Not and I. You're making your change on and. Yeah. Try it, just to see what happens. For the Lord God of hosts, right?
For the Lord God of hosts, many tables for the Lord God of hosts, and I...
No, you did him in. You slowed down. You led him there. Keep going. Don't slow down. Doesn't say one word in this score that you have to slow down. All right? Let's go again.
For the Lord God of hosts, many tables for the Lord God of hosts, and I, even I.
No, make something of it. And I, even I. Then sort of go back into tempo.
Even more.
I think you can allow yourself that license. All right. And the Lord God of hosts right there.
The Lord,
sorry.
Yeah.
Start the same place. So for the Lord God of hosts.
For the Lord God of hosts. Mary Jane is for the Lord.
You got a chance to sing really beautiful here. I even I hold it on. Only I'm really milk it. Okay? Same place.
For the Lord God of hosts.
Wait, hold it. Seek.
Seek my life.
I'm hearing seech.
Okay.
It's k.
Yeah, well, I know it's k. You hear?
I'm hearing. I swear to you, I'm hearing siege.
Oh, I believe you.
Just start from. Okay, I'm going to ask you to do something. I think you're missing a big bet here by taking a breath. Take it away, it is enough. No breath.
Okay.
Got to prepare for it. So you have to, when you're taking your breath before, take it. And you can also, you could breathe just before away in order to justify not breathing when it's coming up. But I think you're missing a great bet.
Okay.
It's very effective. Okay. And they seek my life to take it away, take it, and you're going to breathe before away. Get that in your head. That's it. Okay.
I beseech my life to take it, to take it.
Okay, so one of the things you have to do when you're doing again, that's a show-off thing, right? But it's a great show-off. Not all show-offs are great, but they can be. You have to telegraph it or send out a rocket that shows people that you're not breathing. You cannot make it sound. Yeah, you cannot make, you cannot make like a. Anything that you gotta, I think a little slide will do it.
Okay.
Try it. Just sing, and they seek my life to take it. In the middle of the fourth stanza, fourth staff. Yeah, that's it. That's it. Suspension, keep the sustaining into the next one. It is. Last time, do it again. Good. Can you get sing that away here? Away instead of. You're trying to get some kind of extra support with your chin.
Okay.
Try it. If you crack, we don't care. It's only us. That's all. It's only us.
Me and you.
And you know the old joke on singers, the only voice free enough in town to still crack. They didn't get it. But you see, you're trying to get it with your lips now instead of to take it away. Get it up there.
And they seek my life to take it, away. It is enough.
You forgot to breathe. your brain went back. All right, last time.
Yeah.
We gotta go.
Unbeseech my life, to take it, away, it is enough.
I'm sorry, I just wanna point out one thing. You see, one of the reasons to maybe make the slight slide is you've got to get the orchestra resonance out before you make that. Before you make that not breathing. I can't say the word, sorry. Wait, you've got to get the orchestra out of the way. Because they only got one beat, but they have a little bit of resonance left over, right?
So I gotta wait for this.
Wait, it is. But you must take a bigger breath. I was going to yell breathe and I didn't.
Yeah.
Take it away. You gotta get a good breath. Make it ugly.
I tried.
No, she...
More eh than a.
Eh.
Okay. And to seek my life, and to seek my life, to take it, to take it away.
Sustain, keep sustaining. Sustain. Good. Put a slight accent on die. Now let me die. Just a slight, right there.
Now let me die.
Now take your time. I would take more time. Sometimes the orchestra comes in, by the way, afterwards. That's up to the conductor.
Before the My Life, you would take more time.
Oh, yeah. I would take more time. Okay. You have nothing underneath you. It's dead for the orchestra. So when you, and also, you're still singing away and away. Take away my life, you've got to sell the end.
Okay.
I hate to use the word sell, but that's what you have to do. So let's just do the Lord, take away, take your time. And breathe after Lord. Good, bravo. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
2 minutes to stretch your knees.
Yes.
Oh. only time I ever heard it.
Yeah, me too. Night of the Seven Stars.
Later. Okay, this is not an intermission. This is now we're going to sit again. Thank you. What? No, thanks. Okay. What? What? I have it right here. Hi. How are you?
My pleasure.
Welcome. Hi. Hi. Yes, we know each other already. Pleasure. Okay. All right. Yeah. You got to do it all. So, you say Erin?
Erin
Colleen.
That's right,
Laurent.
Laurent.
Yeah, right. And, okay. So, Erin, do you have to say Erin Colleen together?
Erin is fine.
Erin.
Colleen got dropped a long time ago.
Oh, okay. So, tell me about you. So that makes you about 24, 25, 6, 7, 8, 9, 30.
I took a bit of a break between my bachelor. It's a long story.
That's okay.
But I'm 32.
So you must be really great.
Changing techniques and trying new repertoire and trying to use my full voice. Seems I wasn't using my full voice before, so.
Sing louder, I mean speak louder for the public.
Pardon me. So learning to use my full voice before I was singing repertoire that was a little lighter. Now I'm learning to sing more, let's say, full-bodied repertoire.
Good.
That does change things physically.
Full-body support.
Exactly.
This is one of the things, by the way, that I think is in great need among teachers, that a lot of teachers are loath to teach support. And support is the ball game. That's unfortunately the hard. You have to really work hard with your body. So I'm glad to see that you're shaking your head and you know all of that. So you've probably come through a situation where you didn't support your voice, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, the connection between this and this is that's it. And I have nobody else to quote other than the great UC Burling, who said that to the great Richard Miller, who was a famous teacher. Richard was still singing, and he and Burling became friends in San Francisco, and he went to hear him sing. Went to hear Richard sing. And he said, look, whenever I feel I'm in trouble, I think of this, and I think of this. That's it. And I couldn't agree more. Okay, so, this brings us to basically some lighter repertory, which has been sung by big sopranos. We know, obviously Joan and Callas. You know, those ladies had big, big, big voices. So there's no question that this repertory was written for fuller voice lady. It was Pasta, right? Yes. Pasta?
That's right.
Yeah, that's right. Okay, so do you know what's happening here in the opera?
Yes, the opera is called The Sleepwalker. So essentially, this is the final scene of the opera. What brings us here is she's an orphan who was taken in by Teresa, who is in charge of the mill. And essentially, she sleepwalks into another man's room while she's betrothed to another. And then her marriage is canceled. And long story short, she's walking on the edge of a precipice and she's sleepwalking, speaking the words about how her love lasted only but a day, thinking about her wedding ring that was taken back, or her engagement ring, pardon me. And and also the flower that withered that he gave her upon their betrothal. Essentially.
Okay.
So it starts quite sad, and then the second half is completely different, demands something completely different as well in expression. And at this point, she's awakened to find the villagers there, and her betrothed, Elvino, has understood that she was innocent in the end, and so everyone is rejoicing, and the marriage is back on.
All that.
All in one scene.
Right. All right, so let's put you in your sleepwalking trance. And away we go. It's a tad slow. Okay, let's start it. I'm sorry. I'm going to stop you too soon, I know. You woke up a little fast. a little. I think you've got to keep this. You have to keep this really supported. I wouldn't take that breath, by the way. I know it's an exclamation point, but if you take it, you must connect it. Really connect it. Get your support underneath you. Okay, wait, hold on. You're slightly under the pitch, and it's oh instead of ah, yeah. Get the placement a little bit higher, and try not to be nervous. Remember, I've been where you are. I know what it's like. So get your support underneath you first, and then you won't be nervous. Watch your chin. It's sticking out. Pull it down. Support. Thank you. Obviously, you have an easy, at least it sounds easy, easy top, really high notes. So what you lack is how to sell them. You know, this kind of music sounds fairly simple, except obviously, blah, 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 and all that is not easy to sing. But you have to make your points when you, for instance, even how to time your very last note. That times it. If you just sort of don't time the rhythm, it throws it away. You just did all that incredibly hard stuff and you threw away the end. But we have to go back now. I made you sing the whole thing, first of all, to get rid of your nerves, and secondly, to show if you have the stamina, because one of the things to sing these arias is the stamina, because they're hard. And you've got to have all your poop underneath you, even at the end. Okay, let's start. And Anoncredea is has to think beautifully, think of your most gorgeous tones, and be careful about jerking the rhythm, because she's sleepwalking. And if she jerks, she might fall off, right? Mm-hmm. So you've got to keep it quite smooth, but you have to sing every damn note. This music, you have to be perfect. You can't slop it at all, all right? You have to put that in your head. I have to be perfect. I can't leave out any notes, which you occasionally did, mm-hmm. Okay? All right, just two bars before. Here's the tempo. It's written andante cantabile. You know what cantabile means? Mm-hmm. Sing. And it's piano, right? No, why do you do that? You have a very good tone. You went and pulled your lip and your chin, right here. Watch me. You got to watch your chin.
Okay.
You know what you do when you're using your chin like that? You know what you're doing? You're trying to find support. Support comes from here, okay, and here, and here, all right? Again, please. Support. See, well, I didn't like what you just did there. You went instead of keep it smooth now. You're going to have time to do all your acrobatics, but try to sing in a really legato, smooth line. Watch out, because what you do is you get a nice start of a tone, and then you go. You lower your chin.
Okay.
See, I believe in keeping the support rather than going for your chin.
Okay.
When you support, do you stick out or you stick in?
I try to stick out.
Yeah. And support the hell out of it. You know, you really need to use your bum. I'm telling you.
That's see that in your book. And
yeah.
It does help.
Yeah, it does help. Okay. Can we just start from can we get Che un giorno solo? Wait, I have something to say. Si presto estinto, oh, don't make it jerky.
Okay. I feel like I need to get off.
A lot of ladies don't even breathe there, but it's fine because he did write a rest there.
Okay.
Just start that, si presto.
Si presto, istinto, avere, passosti, avere l'amore.
Yet. Che un giorno solo, right?
Che un giorno solo. Che un giorno solo.
Lovely, lovely, lovely. Singing here. I have to say something. When you come down to the A on Duro, keep your support. Sing through. Italians, the good Italians sing through their phrases, right through and sustain to the end. All right? So it comes on, giorno sol duro. Don't let it, right there on che un giorno. Double V coming. No, maravibar. That's where it is. Okay. Il pianto mio. A little bit of accents on those notes. Il pianto mio reca. Right there. Sorry, I led you astray. Okay, start Potria. Okay. Potria nova. All right, think of this smiling here. What happened was, car went back. Il pianto, il pianto mi ricordi, not car. You hear the difference?
Yes.
Keep it all right here. Okay. Il pianto mio.
Il pianto mi ricordi.
Better. Now. Loud, soft, take your time.
I always feel stressed there.
What?
That's a stressful part because you feel like you need to start right away. So
No. I don't credere. Take a good breath. Let's go back. I non credere. Right there, the first one. Forte and then piano. No, really, make a difference. Make a difference also on the ah. You're singing ah non credere ah non subito piano. Good breath. Move. Watch me. Sorry. Yeah, I know you couldn't. I want to guide you because you need to do a little bit of turning of rhythms here. Do you know it? So just sing, pasa si al par, right there. Going. Okay, you know you can also sing sa sti. I'm in the wrong key, sorry. Sa sti. Passasti al park. Stop. Damor. I also don't like it if you repeat the G. I like it if you sing Damor. You have to learn how to do this.
I
see. Well, you'll do it now, okay? All right, let's go back. If I'm overrunning my time, just leave if you have to. Que un giorno sol duro, right there. Sorry, let's go back to Pasasi al par. Oh, of course. Of course, I'll have some too.
Thank you.
Listen, it's not Paul Sa, it's Paul Sa. Go. You can't take that breath.
Oh, I took
it. Do it right from there, from the G. Passasti al par. No, where the breath really is. Pa-sa-sti. That's it, but it's like a quick sigh. Pa-sa-sti. It can't be more than that.
And then I may breathe before demo.
Yeah. Like that. It's I don't like that rush. Right. No, sing da. Did he sing da more the whole time? Da. See, I don't like that run, that you speed it up like that. You've got to feel this limpidness again of the sleepwalking. More. Well, so what, in order to make the second one easier, you have to sing louder on the first one.
Okay.
Sing right there. Can you sing that soft? Can you sing that soft? Just try it.
I'll try.
Remember, it's just us. You're singing beautifully. You have
Thank
a
you.
Wonderful voice.
Thank you.
Beautiful voice.
Thank you.
Just enjoy it, every minute of it.
Yeah, I'm still a little.
Da-da-da-da-da-da.
Sorry.
That doesn't matter.
Thank you.
You know what? I think you're afraid of it. That's all. You've got it. So, but when you're on it, give more support. Get extra support. Your back, your behind, you know, your legs, everything. Just give extra support. I think it's, you've got it. Just trust it.
Okay.
Last time. Now, why do you have to crescendo?
On the top of the first one?
No, the second one. Can't you go sweet. I know I'm demanding a lot,
no,
but you know what? So does the public.
Yes. Okay.
Remember, I told you have to be perfect. No pressure. Okay, watch it. You got to watch these pitches on the high side. You know, you have a pitch. You say it's like this. This is the pitch. This is the low side of the pitch, and this is the high side of the pitch. These always need high. They need slightly the high side of the pitch. You're just a little under, and when that orchestra comes in and you're not exactly right, that's so awful. It's so awful. You also have to be prepared. If you're already flat, you have to be prepared to hear the orchestra and in an instant go up. You know? I've rarely heard people be sharp, I can tell you that. All right, last time. Sing, don't rush it. You know what I'm going to I'm picking on you, I know that, but I have to pick. Have you ever heard about giving it more space when you're trying to sing piano?
Yes.
So if you're thinking, pulling the voice like that into that high space where you have, you know, like a crescent moon, you're smiling, you know?
Yes, like the lift.
Yeah. Feel it. This is the direction. Pull it this way. You know, like across your jaw and up. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
Okay, try it again. Just see what happens. And support. It's hard. It's not easy. This is not child's play.
No. I always want to go back to the lower note because I'm so used to it, right? So I think da, and then I'm like, da.
Now, that's perfectly acceptable, okay? It's not great. You didn't sing loud, soft.
I was trying to.
I know. Smile. But give it good space.
Okay.
Acceptable? But no cigar. You have to work on the other. You have to work on it. I think you can get it easily. You just have to find the feeling. Remember, singing is a series of sensations. You've got to get that sensation. I feel you will get it. So now let's leave this and go on to greater glory. This was pretty good, by the way. This is, you know, you did well. Although some of the coloratura is still a little sloppy.
I wasn't calm. I wasn't grounded.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. I'm sorry, I'm going to stop you. I hate to do this. I hate to do this. You must be sure that you've got the tempo. If you don't hear your tempo from the orchestra or from the piano, you've got to set it the minute you come in.
Okay.
Do you like this tempo?
It's a little slow.
What?
It's a little slow.
He wrote allegro moderato. Okay. All right, then you can take care of it when you come in.
And set it. Okay.
Excuse me. I'm sorry. I forgot your name, dear. What is it?
Aaron.
No, him.
Oh, my.
Jeremy. Jeremy. Jeremy, are you on purpose going slower in the introduction and then speeding it up when you get to the formula? Okay. All right. All right. Still too slow? I think you need to lighten it up too. You're singing a little heavy. And also smile. Okay? So let's start again.
Okay.
Mcha, 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 right there. Light. Step forward for the West Coast. Okay?
Okay.
So when you hear that music, step forward.
just do the cadenza? Or?
Let him play the interlude again. Smile. It all the way. You have to. I'm just going to point out some really picky stuff, buddy. You must check always what the guy wrote when he wrote something like in like sempre insieme, sempre uniti in un. Look at this. In una speme. You sang speme. Yeah. You do what the guy wrote. It's better. It's always better, you know, until you want to change it, of course. But I think you really cracked this today, don't you think? No, what I mean.
Last E is usually much better, but I felt this time went much better than the first.
Well, yeah, and also, and it was correct. You were singing it really, really correctly, and then that's just great. You might figure out, since you've got such great high notes, you might figure out a better ending. Well, look at that one. going to.
I used to do
that
it.
D. Why did you give it up?
I don't know. Just
you can't take the easy way out.
Okay. That's what I did.
Yeah, you really, you did.
It's so much that I thought at the end, do I really need to do after I've done all of that?
Now, I'm going to tell you something else. You have a weight problem. I understand that from the grave, infancy to the grave. Don't let anybody tell you to get thin, all right? The most you need to lose is maybe 20 pounds, 25 max, all right? Do not lose weight because it's not good for your voice. We have seen the examples of too many people who've had bypass surgery in their stomach, you know, the bariatric, and they lose their voices. I know so many people that's happened to. And if you get too thin, it's the same thing. Even if you don't have surgery, just take it easy, 20 to 25, that's all you need. You got a great face, you have a wonderful voice, go for it.